Continuing our DevOps trend for this afternoon, we have João Maia from EDP, who's going to be talking about how EDP do DevOps and how that incorporates with Agile over at the company. So please give a round of applause for João.
Hi, everyone. I'm going this short presentation talk a little bit about our experience in going into Agile in a corporate where we have several companies. We have the production, generation, renewables, distribution, commercialization, and so on, and each with its own systems, with its own culture, and how we have been tackling all these difficulties around Agile and DevOps. A little bit of history, we started with the first Agile team in 2012. It was not really an Agile team because we have all these waterfall processes, complex, heavy processes. But we started with one team implementing things a little bit different. And it was a huge success. So we started with several small teams. And in 2016, due to all the success we had, EDP has adopted Agile and Waterfall both as a way of working. So from 2016 up till now, we have two very distinct ways of working. One is Agile, and another is traditional Waterfall. And this Agile way of working is a way that encompasses all the process, from budgeting to hiring people to developing, testing. Everything is done in an Agile way. By the end of last year, 2018, we had over 50 products working in Agile. We have more than 500 people working daily full Agile. And by the end of 2021, our aim is to have all the IT development in Agile. First, going a little bit back, why do we care about Agile and why all this fuzz around Agile? Well, for us it was important because, first, our time to market was not that good. We were struggling to put things out in the market that were crucial for our company. Second, we had lots of inefficiencies. So we were looking a lot into how many features we are delivering, how many mobile apps we are delivering, how many, and that's not real value. So we worked a lot on, is this app going to deliver value or not? What is our business aim? And according to the business aim, we will develop and iterate to reach that goal. It also increases collaboration. Just in order to understand, our development teams are usually in outsourcing. So we have over 1,500 people working in outsourcing with EDP. So there are a lot of companies, very different ways of working, and usually we worked in silos. So there was someone that worked the requirements, someone that did the architecture, someone that did specifications, someone that did technical specifications, someone that implemented, someone that tested, and then in the end, someone that looked if that was something that brought value to the company. And through the process, a lot of things changed, and this wasn't really working. So we went back to the Agile Manifesto. Probably you know about it. These are four very simple principles that are very difficult to implement in a huge company. First, to value individuals and iterations over processes and tools. It's very easy to define processes, tools. We must comply with all these framework that we have developed. But most important of it is people. Are we delivering what people want? Are we listening to our customers? First, this is the first rule. Second, working software. It seems pretty straightforward. We are delivering working software, but it's not that easy during the process to focus on this part. So usually we focus on developing a very good specification with 300 pages. On these 300 pages, we know exactly how the system will work, but then in the end, it doesn't work according to the what we have specified, or it works according to the specified, but it's not what we need in the market, okay? Customer collaboration over contract negotiation. If I define a contract that I need to deliver to you an application with three screens, you will get an application with three screens. But probably you don't need an application with three screens. You need to solve a problem. And maybe you need five screens and not three screens. And this collaboration is crucial so that in the end we have a good result. Responding to change over following a plan. For many years, the success of a project was it was delivered on time, on budget. I won't say how many projects we delivered on time and on budget that in the end the client didn't use. So we were having full success with implementations that weren't being used by the final client. So what we did in 2016 was we created an Agile Center of Excellence with experts, with these Agile coaches, that started to implement a different way of working. Working with people, changing processes, changing tools, changing everything within the company to deliver software in a different way. And this is what we have been doing for these couple of years. As a core framework, we use Scrum. Most of you probably know it. Scrum doesn't tell you how to deliver good software. It is a framework that helps how to manage stakeholders, teams, but on top of this, you need software engineering practices, you need testing practices, you need DevOps practices. Otherwise, you have a process that doesn't deliver value. And that's very important to take into consideration. So in 2016, we started with this project. Just to give you two examples, this is our customer self-care portal, EDP Online. We changed the way of working with EDP Online. All the team focused on the business value, which is this NPS. NPS is a measure that measures the satisfaction of our customers that go to the and interact with the portal. And the release of the new version that was made in with this new agile way of working was in March, and in a couple of months we increased the NPS in 81%. This was the best NPS we had ever had. The difference was all the team was focused on increasing the NPS, not on delivering features that probably didn't brought any value, but on increasing the NPS. Second, we changed all the platform that deals with collections and payments. So this is a very core system for EDP. Because if this doesn't work, we don't receive money, and that's important for us. And this was the first project we did on a core application. So sometimes we hear that Agile doesn't apply to core systems, only to sites and apps and stuff. Well, it applies, it works. And we did all the new platform in Agile, and we deliver it in 6 months, okay? The plan for delivering in Waterfall was 10 months. This was the plan. It was very difficult to fulfill. In Agile, we did it in 6 months. Not because we deliver faster, but because we aimed at what was really important, and we focused on delivering value. So as we work in Agile, one of the things that comes comes with Agile, it's the DevOps. You had the previous talk talking a lot about DevOps. What I will say is that we have a huge challenge within EDP because we have over 300 different applications just in Portugal and Spain. Each application has a different technology stack. Okay, we have SAP systems, Oracle, Takeover, OutSystems, in Google with PHP, Java, .NET Core, Python, you name it. And it's very difficult to set a framework, a DevOps framework for all these applications and different technology stacks. So what we did is we worked on an EDP framework. Each team that works in Agile will work in a DevOps pipeline, and that DevOps pipeline is specific for that specific technology stacks and must fulfill these 11 principles, okay? And for each principle, we have guidelines, but then the team must incorporate these guidelines in their stack. We are talking about automation. We are talking about vertical slice. Vertical slice is very important because it allows us to have a part of all the value that we are delivering. If we have an application, we will try to develop a user story incorporating all the layers, front-end, middleware, database, core systems, so that we can deliver that feature, and that feature is autonomous. Okay. And this is very difficult with our systems. But with this framework, what we started was creating DevOps pipelines for these specific stacks. First, guarantee a centralized version control. Then have isolated development so that we can have each user story with its own branch. And then we can test it independently and then just put it in production as soon as the product owner says, okay, this is done. Automated builds, so this was the third point. Quality, code quality. We are making sure that our pipelines don't put in production if specific criteria isn't met. Integrated tests, automated deployment, zero downtime. This is not feasible in every technology, but this is our aim. And auto-change registration, which means that each change that is done in application is centralized, and we have a catalog of everything that happened on each application, on each module. Not everything is done, as you can see. We have a lot of blue and white circles. We wanted to have everything on green. But those that are red are technologies that cannot deliver that kind of feature. So what we are working now is creating a blueprint for microservices. Maybe most of you have heard about it. Microservices is a different way of thinking applications, a different way of developing. And we are creating a blueprint so that we can set a specific boundary and all the partners that work with us can work on that framework. And then each team can choose which language they will develop, can have some autonomy in some specific things. But the blueprint is the same. This for us is important. Otherwise, we would have 300 different pipelines, and that's very difficult to manage then. So this pipeline makes sure that we have all the unit tests, regression tests, performance tests, isolated development, everything in a microservices architecture. So this is the DevOps pipeline we have. Those are all the tools that are integrated with our CI/CD pipeline. And this is something that we are working now because we are shifting a lot into microservices architecture. Some numbers. In Agile, we have trained more than 700 people. I think that currently in Portugal, we are the company that has the most people working fully Agile. We have business units that are working now fully in Agile. All development done in that business unit is in Agile. We have 6 Agile coaches, and we need more working with these teams. We have over 700 Agile products, and we have over 300 DevOps pipelines, okay, and increasing. Some in the past years, EDP has been recognized as an Agile reference, because we have been made a huge effort into this strategy. Lots of products that have been receiving prizes and recognition in different events. And I think this is all because we have changed the way of developing. And this starts to notice, to be noticed across the business. We have been doing a lot of events. We had recently the DevOps Days, the first DevOps Days in Portugal that was in EDP. We have the Experience Agile. That's the yearly event that is made here in Lisbon. And EDP is the host of the event. Because we really believe that this is crucial so that we can meet our customer needs. Just to conclude, some challenges we have, and these are challenges that we invite you to help us with it. First, we are supporting a full-scale Agile cross-geography. Portugal, Spain, Brazil, and all the other geographies. And we need manpower to do it. Cloud development, we are going full cloud in the next couple of years. So currently, new developments are all made in cloud-native applications. And we really need people that help us guaranteeing the quality, core components, and the implementation of this blueprint across teams. Technical expertise, we talked about microservices. It's something that is very difficult to get this kind of expertise, real expertise. And in the end, we have all these DevOps to work on, implementation of pipelines, evolution of pipelines, definition of pipelines with all those tools you saw. And these are things that we are working now and that are crucial so that we can deliver value to our customers with the less effort possible. Thank you.